Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Darkest Dungeon adventure here in week 71. The siren is down and I feel good because man do I hate that fight. So for those of you who may not have seen the earlier Isaac run today, apologies about the lack of content in the last couple days, even though I know that it's just been Darkest Dungeon and I'm sure that a lot of you are okay with that. I've been extremely busy with the past couple of days doing a couple of life changes on top of just getting a different schedule for recording down, and it's also been kind of not helped by the fact that I've been busy with daytime streams, in particular with the Paladin streams that I did with NL, and then the Battleborn tournament that we did the other day as well, which was a lot of fun and great. It's kind of put a little bit of a hamper into my recording schedule, so I apologize about that, but we're getting back on target. And, yeah, we're settling back in here. So let's take a look at what we got right now, shall we? Because I have to kind of reacclimate myself as well as far as where we're going. We got a long one here in the Weald. We do need to kill the Brigand 12-pounder eventually. Are we ready for that? Not quite, because we need to get Ro up there. Ro is going to be very instrumental. Ro or Ken. If we bring Ken, though, we're going to need to have another upfront damager, or a DPS, which is it has to be either Dan or Boogie at this point, because we don't have Davis. We can't use Davis or Frag, as everyone's too high level for that. So it's looking like we're going to have to do a low run, although with both of these guys in the Sanitarium, that might not be possible. In fact, looking at it right now, we have way too many vessels, like way too many. I mean, we could fight the Prophet. Do we have enough to fight the Prophet? We've got Frag. We've got Davis, who is not level 6. But we've got Tempo, who is level 6. So if we go Frag, Tempo. Jenna. Strippin is not a good pick for the Prophet because he can't hit the Prophet. Septimus would be okay to buff everyone's dodge. Dodger could go, but she's very undergeared right now. The Prophet is not a fight you want to come into with any sort of second guessing. It's a very dangerous fight. I think if we bring everyone and Kurt or Sept, the dodge that we can get might be worth it. Although I'm still a little apprehensive. Dodger could go. How much would Dodger's upgrades be, man? She would require a lot of upgrades. Like a lot. She needs, let's take a look at this. Does she even have level 5 moves yet? No, she doesn't. Okay, yeah, so we can't do this with Dodger. And actually, looking at this, we also might not be able to do this, period. It would almost have to be Strippin. Oh boy, I don't know. Krendor. If Krendor went, he wouldn't need as many upgrades. But the problem is that we don't have anyone. We wouldn't have anyone up front anyway. We can't do it. We would need to like upgrade them now and then do another run later. So we can't do a boss kill this time around. Let's see, what do we have for mid tier? We don't even have a healer. Oh, actually, we do have a healer. Yeah, we can do a mid tier. Let's go for it's either long. Long in the Cove or Long in the Weald. We gotta do Cove, as much as I don't want to. But that's okay. We'll make it work. Do we have a... We do not have a Jester. For a long run in the Cove. We gotta go with Crusader... Crusader Stress Heals. I don't want to. But we're gonna have to. We also need to make sure we don't overlevel anyone here. Bring TB along. Is TB... Which one of them... Neither one of them have Cove Scouters. Okay. Yeah, this is definitely a mixed bag. I can tell you that. Alright. So H of the Husky Husky. We'll bring him that. This was his head. For Scrub Victa, we'll give him... focus, as well as extra protection. Let's see here, just I think we'll give him. Well, let's give him legendary bracer in case we do actually get to attack. Now for Krendor, we're gonna go poison herb, as well as we can give him a little bit of speed if we want our dodge. Let's just give him all the blight. And then for TB, we'll give him heal. Alright. So it's not gonna be fun. This is gonna be a nasty run, especially with it being long. But we gotta do what we gotta do. And desperate times calls for desperate messages. We need money. We don't have enough to fund the current needs of our top tier. Which is kind of the reason why we're doing this. So we're doing this for money, but we're also doing this just so... Well, it's just for money. We also need to level up the cove as well, as far as like the progression goes. Probably don't need that many. We'll definitely take extra shovels here. Anti-venom, don't really need anti-venom. Torches, almost forgot torches. All right, I'm not gonna go too crazy on torches. We'll see how it goes. Again, with Crusader stress heals, this is terrifying.
The smell of rotting fish is almost unbearable.
Terrifying, but I think we'll be able to make it somehow. I hope anyway. I actually was just getting ready to move Invicto, but that's okay. So there we go. We got a Crusher up first. And the Crushers do the very nasty arterial pinch, which is the nasty bleed. That's what we have Cry for. I should have probably dropped his damage a bit, but we already know that the Oracle's dead. So there's the arterial pinch. It goes on Cry. He does get bled for 8 damage, which kind of sucks. We'll start working on my stress right away. Again, we know the Oracle's dead, so we don't care about him. Gently. This Cry. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna heal his bleed right now. Because I think TB could do it, and I wanna start getting the blight rate. The blight ticking on the Crusher. 21 heal by TB. I'm all over the place today. We cannot fall behind on stress at all. Battle Slam, it's going to activate the riposte from Husky, resist the stun, which is nice. 10 damage on the Crusher. Nice heal by TB. Got the bleed, unfortunately. Right, so he's dead next turn. Another pinch on Cry, who resisted it, which is good.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
So let's go ahead and cure Cry and Husky's bleeds here. Because we know he's dead.
Prodigious size, there we go. Alone does not dissuade the sharpened.
No harm,
blade.
No foul. Torchlight's at 100 thanks to inspiring Cry. No pun intended, of course, Cry. That's a good start. Right, let me move Sinvicta back so we can lead off with a Holy Lance here. Right, we got the surprise, which is good. Noxious Blast up front. Then let's
obliterated.
We'll go for the one shot. We'll heal up Cry. Got the bleed, unfortunately. Got the kill on the Fusilier, which is good. So the only thing bad about this is that it puts Cry right up front, but Sinvicta and Husky both have a way of leapfrogging Cry, so it's not a big of a deal. My problem is, of course, Cry can't attack from that position, but that's okay.
A singular strike.
All right, and the poison should kill him. This is one off lethal, so 2-11. A nice crit heal. 11 stress heal off
great
that.
Great is
beautiful.
The weapon that cuts on its own.
Good job, me. Actually, we may not use the Holy Lance opener because I've heard, does he have Wicked Slice? Incision. No, he does not. Okay, fair enough. I also forget that Sinvicta is always going to go behind Cry. Unless Cry gets stunned because of the fact that he's got Legendary Bracer on right now. Lots of curios. This is 90% of rooms explored, so we've got a long way to go.
A fortune waiting to be spent.
I mean, it's not really a fortune, Uncle Wayne. We need gold. 75 gold mandas, I'm not worried about. Torch.
Finding the stuff is only the first test.
Right, sorry, Deeds.
Now it must be carried home.
Gold is the name of the game right now.
A handsome reward for a task well performed.
Another surprise, which is great. And we should start. Yeah, let's start working the back line. It's tempting to go for the high protection target, but honestly, we can take them out. Like, they don't do much damage here. Definitely want to drop this damage. I picked the wrong move, though, so I'm an idiot. Just dodged by Cry. Alright. Heal going 48 crit by TB. Good lord, TB. That's a monstrous crit. So they are both dead.
Death. Unforeseen. Unforgiving.
There we go. 1,000 gold's pretty good.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
This is a much nastier group this time around. So again, we'll have Cry work on the back line to get the groupers out, or the wide mouth, as soon as possible. We actually got the knockback, which is hilarious, because that doesn't usually ever happen to the Crusher. And then we'll use a Weakening Curse on the back one. Just drop his damage a bit. 37%. Actually, more than a bit. It's a lot. And then we'll use Zealous Accusation here. Arturo Pinch on Cry. Good dodge. This is Zealous Accusation. Both of them are dead. No big deal at all. Activate the Riposte for Husky.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
Not the Blight. So drop his damage by a lot. Although it doesn't affect his dots, which is okay. Still trying to pinch Cry, which is impressive. Got through Cry's, 50%. Yeah, I like that. Why not? 16 damage by Husky. Alright, we don't want that ticking on Cry, so we're gonna have Cry heal himself here. And we'll also heal Cry. 24 TB, rocking the heals as always. Fortunately, he got the bleed, so still trying to pinch Cry. Good resist. Let's see. Alright, so the Crusher's dead this turn. We can just heal up Cry if we want to, even though he doesn't really need it. Activate Riposte, why not?
The greater the glory.
Okay, let's see here. I'd like the 500 gold, please. I don't want to get rid of the holy water. Alright, we don't have to camp now, but I kind of want to open the chest. Okay, we'll clear this hallway and then we'll come back, camp, and then open that curio. This time around, we're gonna focus the stingers down before the wide mouth because they can do a lot of annoying things like stress. Not stress, but stuns. So I want to take them out. We will drop a curse of weakness on the wide mouth. just to nerf their damage a bit. Man, everyone's dodging everything for some reason. I'm okay with that.
Decimated.
One shot by Husky. One as shot by Crusader Light Day.
A faint hope blossoms.
Toss is active on Husky now. We'll throw out a backline blade. Two off lethal. Never mind. TB takes care of that in no time. Fair enough. So that's what we'll do. We'll clear these two hallways, turn around, and then camp inside of the room with the giant clam, and then we'll open it after we're done camping. They're golden, sure.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
Alright, AoE damage is not something that this group is equipped to handle. So it's in our best interest to take down this group as fast as possible. TB could actually kill him. No, he can't. Let's drop his damage away. A little bit sad that that wasn't able to hit. Yeah, that's that is the type of damage this group is not equipped at all to handle right now.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy.
Occultists are great at doing single target heals, but they are abysmal when it comes to AoE heals. Big heal by TV. We have the Fusilier's dead. Gonna drop an Noxious Blast on top of the cutthroat.
Their formation is
one off lethal.
Broken. Maintain the offensive.
All right, game. All right.
In radiance, may we find victory.
Throw out an extra heal here. We know he's dead anyway. I was hoping that TB would go, but what can he do?
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
So that fight really accents the problem with having an occultist healer is that, especially imagine if TB was actually rolling like we usually get, which is like sub 10. You're looking at hard times. So we're gonna camp inside of here, and it's gonna free up at least one, possibly even two, inventory spots. That's gonna make the gains a lot better. Alright, so we camp. Don't really need to use
circle
a full piece
the
here.
The battle
we'll use
may
a four just to get
won.
A little bit of extra heal. Alright, Bandit Sense for sure, along with Clean Guns. I think that Azel's Vigil would be okay. I don't think anyone has any disease. 20% damage would be nice, but let's see. You know what? I'm actually going to go for the heals receive. No, let's go for 20% damage. That's silly. We'll give it to Scrubbig. No, we'll give it to Husky. I actually meant to use heal there, but oh well.
The promise of safety.
A little bit sloppy on that. Right, that was not.
Treasure could staunch
that was totally not worth.
Otherworldly corruption.
Not worth the gold at all.
Wealth beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike. Glittering gold,
we probably won't be leaving with those
crests. Paid for in blood.
So Bandit Sense will allow us to get a jump on our enemies, and it also prevented the nighttime ambush.
The way is lit, the path is clear.
So far, this dungeon has a whole lot of nothing. Here we go. This is a much more interesting group here. Got a Thrall up front, which hopefully Husky can one-shot. I'm banking on that. Here comes the stress spam. You gotta stay on top of that. Especially when they back-to-back crit.
Palpable fear.
Good hit by Husky for 45. That is not, that is enough to kill him, okay. But we gotta get Sinvicta up front, in front of Cry, but I also don't wanna, we can't skimp on the stress healing now. Especially with the way the game's critting right now. Hoping Husky goes before Cry. He did, good. There we go. Gotta get a heal up on Cry and Husky. Still doing the stress mitigation on TB. We know that he dies next turn anyway. So we use this time to heal everyone up, get some stress healing in order, etc., etc. Actually, gonna pass this turn. Causes a little bit of stress, but I'd rather. Well, that didn't work out quite the way I wanted it to. I wanted to, basically, what I'm trying to say is I wanted to wait until we could heal with TB. So we have a long way to go to catch up on stress, but we can do it.
This expedition at least promises success.
That's a lot of crests. I hate throwing away all these crests, but we kind of have to. We're just not even going to talk about that, thank you. If we had a better group comp, I actually wouldn't be that afraid of fighting the Shambler, but yeah. So this group does not play to our strengths at all, because they've got two AoEers, and again, I've already shown how bad our AoE abilities are to heal. 37, big hit by Husky. Didn't get the move actually, which is surprising. Although they do have a 95% move.
Such a terrible.
And yeah, they're just gonna keep on critting. Keep on the crits. Stress starting to get a little unmanageable here. It'd really be nice if the game stopped getting back-to-back crits. We need to heal, but we should also try to kill these two. So they're both dead, which is good. One off lethal. That guy, we did finally kill him, of course. Let's go ahead and heal up. Stop the bleeding. 31 on Husky, 30 on everyone else, pretty much. Wow, that's been missing a lot, actually. So we need to have some healing in order here. TB's got to heal himself. That was not a big heal, TB. Let's go ahead and Noxious Blast him just so he doesn't get another attack off anyway.
Monster's size has no intrinsic merit, unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
Only reason why I did that is just to free up some inventory. Alright, same plan. 74 for Husky! That would be the biggest hit I've ever seen in the game. Previous record was 68 held by a bounty hunter, but no more. H to the Husky. Husky was 74. Good lord, Husky. That is easily, by far, the biggest hit I've seen in the game from a player. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and take care. Again, we're just going to try to curb the stress as much as possible. Nice crit heal. 13 stress heal and Cry. Man, Husky's going nuts. Alright, let's go for... We could go for a heal to stop the bleeding. Might as well. So I'm for a crit heal. Didn't happen. Alright, let's get a heal up on Scrubvicta. Alright, the procking of that bleed is a little bit silly. I mean, it's not doing a whole lot of damage. It's just annoying that because the word reconstruction heal doesn't usually proc that much. Get Noxious Blast going. Freak, man, Husky. Setting records here.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
So we're looking good, feeling good. Probably not smelling good, but we're looking good. So we know it's clear sail in there. I'm hoping that we do get our secret room.
Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies.
It was just one torch, Uncle Wayne. By the way, people were wondering why I call him Uncle Wayne. His name, the voice actor for the narrator, is named Wayne June, and the uncle part comes in. It stems from the Uncle Decker character. Greetings, hero. Welcome to Darkest Dungeon. I wasn't calling you Uncle Decker. Are you sure? It's been a while since I've been here. I'm sure, Uncle Decker. Just go back to selling keys. You've got yourself a keeper, hero. A keeper. You've got yourself a keeper, hero. Got it, Uncle Decker. I'm gonna hold on to the herbs just in case we do find a coral, which is not looking like all that likely. Alright, come on, secret door. That is not a secret door. I am gonna go up here because we know it's safe. Alright, we got brackish water. I think this is a buff, I wanna say. Oh, we don't have any anti-venom. I think it's anti-venom, not herbs. Yeah, pretty sure it's anti-venom. It's okay. Husky's got 120%. He got rid of all of his stress thanks to just disarming the traps, which I'm happy about. It's better than failing them, that's for sure. Hey! That's what I wanted to see. Alright, so we're gonna go back here and fight this just because we want more gold and I'm getting greedy. The nastiest group we could have not hoped for, but I think we can deal with it.
Impressive.
Nice crit by Cry. Nice crit by TV. So one of them's dead already. Make that two of them. Make that three of them. Okay. And he goes down to dead next turn. So that went a lot better than usual. All right.
Foolish horrors, brought low and driven into the
mud. That might
be
the smoothest I've ever seen a group of three wide mouths ever handled. Usually that group's a little bit more challenging, but we just wrecked them. So I think that we could camp inside of the secret door if we wanted to, or we can wait until after we're done with the dungeon and then use that time to clear up any negative quirks or diseases or stress or anything like that. I think that's probably what we're going to do, as we're not in really any danger in this run. And I realize that that's setting myself up for fail, and I totally understand that, but
another mariner,
so far we haven't seen much to the contrary. Misfortune. Not trying to get cocky here, but we have been doing very well with just Crusader Stress Heals again. I'm actually really surprised at how well the Crusader Stress Heals can hold up to the challenge. All right, so I'm gonna try to burn out the back line here. We're probably not going to be able to one-shot the Bulwark, especially with 50% protection, unless he crits. Should have went for a tracking shot. That also did not crit. Okay, so we've got our work cut out for us here. So let's see if we get punished for starting to be cocky. One more blight grenade, and both of the back line are done. Let's see. Let's take her out just so she can't get stress off. All right, Krendor or Cry would have gone anyway, so that's good to know. But we just want to finish him off. No big deal. Let's get a heal out on Cry. It's not a very big heal, DB. Octus has some Husky. Activate the Riposte. I'm going to stress heal out on DB. Man, they're just whiffing all over the place. Alright, I want to blight up the Guardian just to chew through that protection. Decent heal on himself for TB. 18! Man, oh man. And then he dies to the blight, so yeah. This is one of the worst groups we could have not hoped for, and we easily just tear him down.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Oh yeah. Again, I forgot to use the holy water on that. My bad. Alright, who wants a positive quirk? Scrub Victon needs a positive quirk. Wheel Tactician. Not that helpful in the cove, but I guess I can't complain. Got the surprise. I'm happy that I slid Sinvicta back to 3. So here we go again. This actually did not work out at all the way I wanted it to. People going out of order here, but we got one of them. Alright, they're not using stress this time around, which is good. Call of the Deep is kind of nasty. Especially if they go for TB, which they didn't. Fire kill on one of the wide mouths. Got a heal Husky. That's not the heal I needed, TB, and you bled him, TB! That's not at all what we needed. In fact, that is the very opposite of what we needed right there. Husky's bleed resist is 70. The word reconstruction bleed has been landing a lot more than usual. Heal. 13 stress. We've got to heal Husky. Let's cure the bleed. Nice crit heal by Cry, actually. Alright, big heal, TB. We need a big heal. There you go, TB. Still got the bleed again through 70% bleed resist, but hey. One thing at a time. Paying for it in stress. Never mind. We are not paying for it in stress. We are A-okay. Husky's back. Welcome back, Husky.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
Alright. Let's get rid of our only shovel. Well, one of our last only shovels. At this point, I don't think holy water is really going to matter. So we're just going to chug the holy water to up our resistances a bit. We'll come back and get this chest on the way back, because we've got to go to the secret door. Heirlooms, which we unfortunately don't have enough space to take. Now this is the group that we definitely don't want to see. If we can land a stun here on the back line, that'd be great. Good. The Madman and the Oracle are both very nasty to get it in the same group. Tracking shot. If it crits, it'd kill him. I think I'd rather go for the Madman. Material Pinch on Cry. He's dodged. Thankfully. Still gonna get stress here. He's gonna be 2 off. We gotta hit him for 4. Ah, you hit him for 3, Husky! The 1 off lethal. 1 off lethal. I guess I shouldn't be surprised, really. Darkest Dungeon, you are hilarious. Alright, well, now there's no reason to attack them, so I guess we're just gonna heal. They're both dead. That is not a big heal, DB. Alright, let's stack the blight. It's gonna be a long, long run. Unless Husky does that. 30 damage on 50% protection is pretty impressive. That is about as bad as it gets, TB. World 0 out of 0 to 18, huh? Again, we're trying to keep up with the stress. We've got to. Without a jester, this is just how it is. There we go. That's a much better heal TP. I mean, it's doing surprisingly well. Well, I guess it's not really surprising. We've done Crusader stress heals before, and they're very good. He got a crit, but did not land the. But didn't land the bleed. That's actually impressive. Try heal yourself. TB heal Husky for 10.
Their cursed champion falls.
Right, so that is it. I think we're still going to go. I'm still hoping that we do get an Eerie Coral. So we can purge a couple of negative quirks. If we don't, it's not a huge deal, but... Call me greedy at this point, because we didn't really make a whole lot of gold. Although we still have not gone, I mean, admittedly, so we haven't gone to the secret door yet, but I'm not expecting. I mean, like 7,500 gold is great, it's not that much. Alright, game.
Mind that such missteps are the exception and not the rule.
Might as well take the deeds. Okay. And yes, I am aware that the secret door does count for towards the expiration. I am aware. All right. Well, unfortunately, we don't have any more holy water, so this would have been a negative quirk removal, not the one that I wanted or that I was expecting, but whatever. Let's go for a tracking shot on you. Cry's Blight's gonna be able to kill the Oracle. Pinch on Husky. Cry should be able to take care of that. Start mitigating the stress of Cry. Oracle. Let's get a weakness out on you. Heal up Husky's bleed before it ticks. Oh, we actually got the knockback on the Crusher, which is nice. Now we can hit Victa. Scrub Victa.
A dizzying blow to body and brain.
Crusader leg day never fails. Alright, we got a lot of stress to mitigate here. The thing is, we can still camp and take care of a lot of the stress too, which is good. Actually, you know what? Let's weaken you a bit.
A decisive pummeling.
Still stacking the blight. We're gonna let it do its thing. And just go with Crusader stress heals here.
Well, TB.
I mean, I'll take the crit. The crit heals too. Oh man. Everybody critting. Well, he's dead, so.
A victory.
Alright.
Perhaps the turning point.
Well, I mean, we've already won, Uncle Wayne. It's not a real turning point anymore, but I appreciate the sentiment nonetheless. Alright, so we got two chests to open and the secret door. We're gonna use the rest of our food. I mean, do we camp now or do we wait? I'm actually going to wait to camp. Because I'm hoping that we don't use up any of our food. Although I guess we do have we have eight total, so. Alright, we know that we're not gonna need herbs anymore. And then busts. I mean, we don't need shovels anymore. Yeah, we don't need shovels. They get a respawn. It's fine. As long as that's the last hunger event, we're fine. Actually gonna go for a stun on the Fusilier instead. Just to give our frontline time to chop down the cutthroats. At least one of them anyway. Go for a weakness on you. Satyr leg day never fails. Try for another stun here. Didn't get it. Not that surprising. The riposte should be able to kill him, though. Ah, too off lethal. There we go. 30 gold's good.
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
All right. More gold Reno. So a very long run, but a very good run. As we go in again, another Jesterless run here, and come back not too bad. Let's see, we got 2k, 258. We got like 11,000 ish right now, not including the items. Yeah, we'll just go for it. We'll just go for Blight. We can handle the stress as it comes in. What's more important is killing the Thrall, which Husky should be able to do with one shot. We're actually going to heal here. Just as a precautionary measure. And then Crusader late day crit. Oracle. Actually the wrong mark, but oh well. I'm kind of sad that you don't get stress healing off of
but a victory nonetheless.
Off of dot kills. Like a plague doctor does not get any stress removed for killing with her DOTs. So we're gonna camp here real quick. Use the rest
a
of our food,
of respite.
And then we're going straight for stress healing
against the coming horrors.
So we'll go for Zealous Vigil, Zealous Speech, Stress Heal, and that's that. There we go. And our reward is that much gold. All right. So yeah, very easy.
Despite its morbid,
very easy run here.
This twisted, cavernous maze seems almost traversable.
Wasn't bad for 21,600 gold. We're bringing home 32 G's, almost 33,000 gold. Lots of deeds. For not having a jester, you can't really complain. Cry did go to level 5, which is unfortunate. Tippler kind of sucks. But yeah, I do appreciate the support, everyone. Thank you very much, as well as the understanding. Like I said, the downtime of the of other content outside Darkest Dungeon. I'm looking at ramping things back up to normal as we go into the weekend here. So I'm going to wrap it up there. Good run. Thank you for watching, everyone. I appreciate the support on all of the series. And of course, until next time, so long, everybody!